Yes. As always, a trustworthy, fair exchange. I've procured some new items for you, Mr. Winter. Do let me know if you find anything else of value. Lovely weapon, sir. I was just thinking of ways to pass the time. On such a thing. Please come again.
You really are a tough one. But I'm tired of chit-chat. Time to die. You can hear it, can't you? Someone is waiting for you.
Bullshit! Out of my way!
You really are a tough one. But I'm tired of chit-chat. Time to die. You can hear it, can't you? Someone's waiting for you.
I don't have time for this bullshit. stay down.
What the?
Not bad. Not bad, Rangers. You're persistent. But I've got a rebellion. So stay out of my way.
Again?
I told you to leave it alone, Ethan! You are in the way.
What do you care, Chris? You killed my wife, you son of a bitch!
You think I killed Mia? That wasn't her. It was Miranda.
What?
She's a bioweapon. She changed her appearance and pretended to be Mia. Seems she also survived being shot, so now I'm here to finish the job.
Bullshit! Why don't you fucking tell me right away?
Because I knew you would want to be involved! And this job is hard enough without civilians getting in the way.
Why us, Chris? What the hell is going on?
All right, Ethan. All right. I guess I owe you an explanation.
You can't turn back now. I'm coming, Rose.
A goddamn cockroach! You think you can take me on? Fine! This will be my warm-up before I kill that bitch. Let's settle this. Man, a man. Your corpse will be another addition to my army!
Come on!
Yeah! Tough love! What's wrong, Ethan? That won't hurt, I promise. Hey. Oh, don't give up!
Yourself.
the world wants you. Having fun? Too bad I'm your only fan. Come on! Interest? Come on! Interest? Having fun? Too bad I'm your only fan. So long, Ethan Winters. You really should have taken my deal. You'll be frozen in the afterlife. Lose his power at one. Right after I murdered him. This can't be the end for me. I must kill her!
Captain, I've confirmed the death of Ethan Winters. I wasn't able to retrieve the body, but I've recorded evidence.
Share your screen, and I'll go over the situation. My team and I were careless. Yesterday, we took down the transformed Miranda, but we didn't kill her.
Who knew she could fake being a corpse?
Since Miranda could have infected Ethan, I forcefully took him and Rose with us. But the vehicle they were riding in was attacked. When I got to the wreck, Ethan and Rose were gone. The last time I was able to contact Ethan, I heard Miranda's voice. She murdered him. And she is not gonna get away with it.
Been a while since we fought together, Captain. When was it last? The desert?
Doing nothing but recon's gotten me out of shape.
But thanks to your recon, we know Miranda's plan.
Couldn't quite believe it when I heard she turn herself into Mia, though.
Taking 5 shots to the head's nothing to sneeze at either. Spooky.
Hey, Alpha. Look at this.
The SAA, they've gone too far. Christ.
It looks pretty rough down there. How are you planning on reaching the objective?
First, we're gonna have to take that thing out.
I've got your back, boss. Let's get to work.
Everyone watch for hostile bioweapons.
Roger.
Make contact with a group of hostile bioweapons.
SAA craft spotted. 2 guards. I can take them.
Don't get cocky.
What the hell is that thing? It's all new to my seat.
That's probably where Miranda is. Let's go.
Large mutated bioweapon sighted.
It's me. I'm at the location preparing for support fire. Might be a minute.
Roger.
Tundra here. Leaving some supplies on one of the houses, Captain. Help yourself.
Umbarize, I need some backup.
I see you. 200 to the point.
Colony growing so huge. Hey, I get eyes on your boss. think she died and gone to hell.
I've reached the target location.
Damn, this is big.
All right, Lobo. Marking the target.
Roger that, boss. Reloading now. Just a minute. There's a swarm headed that way.
East side.
I'm nearby. I'll handle them. Another hit. Ah. Looks like it's about to collapse.
Hold your horses. I'm reloading.
It's them. Watch your perimeter.
I found a way down. I'm going in. The rest of you stay back.
Captain, I compared the mold at the village with a sample from the bakers, and there's no sign of the genome editing we saw in the E-series. The stuff originated here.
My seat, huh? Lobo, I got a tough guy here. I'm gonna need backup.
Boss, you're on the ground.
There's an opening in the roof. Use it.
Okay, I'm moving out. Hold on till I get there.
Yeah!
Reloading now. Just a minute.
Keep going. The rest of you, stay above ground.
So if Miranda was the fake Mia, where's the real one?
I doubt she saw any further use for her. I don't get any of this. How did Miranda even know Rose exists?
A moldy little bird told her, maybe?
We can figure that out later. Focus on the plan. I found it. The Megamycete. Alpha to squad. I've located the Megamycete.
So now we can end this mess after all.
About damn time. And two explosives armed. There's enough there to blow the whole village sky high.
Let's get out of here and blow the damn place.
Not before I end Miranda. I'm not taking any more chances. I'm going in.
Roger that. Standing by.
Captain, I have eyes on Miranda at the ceremony site.
Keep your distance. Do not move until I give the order.
I know it's too late now, but we really should have told Ethan the plan.
There wasn't time. We didn't expect Miranda to act so soon.
Even so, you should have told him.
Yeah. This must be Miranda's lab. Show me your hands! Umbrise, this is Alpha. Where is Miranda right now?
Still at the ceremony site. Whatever she's doing, she's staying put.
Goddamn. It really is you. I'm glad you saved Mia. Why are you here?
I was caught in Houston experiments.
Wait, did you say Mia? Mia Winters?
In the flood.
Did I get here?
At last, he awakes.
Where am I?
My carriage, Ethan. You were having a nightmare.
Duke?
Your battle with Heisenberg was a sight to see. But to think Miranda would show herself.
How long have I been out?
Not long till dawn.
Duke, I need a favor. Take me to Miranda.
I assumed as much and am already...
I gotta go.
Preparation is more important now than ever before. Oh, the assemblage of life and machine. I can feel Lord Heisenberg's essence through it. These hands are more dexterous than one might think. This may be our last meeting. Be sure you have all you need. Please, be well.
Thanks.
Daughter. You fulfilled your purpose, Mr. Winters. You disposed of my false children and awakened the glorious Megalysis. Now, please do not worry for little Rose. I assure you I'll provide her with treatment. So now you can die peacefully. You understand the level of appearance.
Not letting you get away!
How can you deny me?
Why the hell can't you realize Rose is my goddamn kid, not yours?
The Megamycete saved me from the pits of despair. It granted me this splendid power.
Yeah, right. All it's done is drive you nuts.
After all, everyone dies. I think it's time you left things in my hands. Go on, please.
The hell I will.
If I combine Rose with a Megamycete, my daughter will be made manifest at last! I've waited a century, all for this day. Your time is up! Now die! Why do you interfere? Surely you have no no need of those now. So close to death.
She's my goddamn daughter, you psycho!
I will not let him or anyone else take her or my daughter.
Long ago, a young girl went with her mother to pick berries for her father, who was hard at work. But the forest greeted them with a dark, cold silence, the bushes empty. Yet determined to find the berries, the rascal broke free from mother's grasp and vanished into the trees. Mother's worried cries faded fast as the girl ran on, over vine and under branch, and into the forest deep. Feeling strange eyes upon her, the girl recalled Mother's scary bedtime tales, and her throat became bone dry. Then the Bat Lord appeared. He greeted her warmly and bit his own wing. "Come, child, quench your thirst," he said. So she drank the thick, dark blood and smiled with joy. Passing through the graveyard, menacing storm clouds loomed, and the air turned bitingly cold. The girl was shivering in her thin clothes. Then a dark weaver appeared, and with a click of his fingers, crafted mist into a beautiful dress. "Come, child, warm yourself," he coaxed. So she clothed herself and smiled with joy. Across waters deep and ominous she went, hoping a boat she found would carry her home. But hunger's grip tightened and her heart grew heavy. Then the Fish King appeared and offered one of his many fins. "Come, child, eat your fill." So the girl ate and smiled with joy once more. Continuing on, she soon entered the forest's dark heart. Then an iron steed appeared, bearing a beautiful golden gear. The creature said nothing as the girl approached and snatched what she thought was another gift. The horse grew angry and summoned the other monsters. Terror filled the girl's heart as the wild wind rose around the beasts. Suddenly, a witch appeared, dark yet regal. "Gifts we gave, but more you took," she snarled. "So more in turn is due." In a blink, the girl was trapped inside a mirror. There. She's asleep.
What is with the creepy story? She's only 6 months old.
Woman at the store said it was traditional. A local tale. Besides, Rose doesn't seem to mind.
Because she doesn't understand it, thank God. We moved here so that she wouldn't have to deal with any of that, remember?
There's nothing wrong with my memory.
You're just being paranoid.
It's not... Never mind. I'm sorry. But I'm not paranoid. I'm just cautious.
Then, go cautiously take your daughter to bed. I'll finish dinner.
It's okay, Rose. Your mother doesn't want to remember, and I can't blame her.
Did you say something?
Nothing. I'll put her down. Like I said to your mom, that book's too scary for you. Almost there, honey. Go, sweetheart. Don't you worry. I'll be right downstairs. Daddy won't let those weird fairy tale monsters get you.
Is she okay?
Sleeping like, well, like a baby. Hmm, that smells good. What's that?
Oh, hands off, mister. It's churba de legume. It's a local recipe.
Wow, you've gone full native, haven't you?
Local wine, too. But if you're gonna keep sulking all evening, maybe you shouldn't have any.